expert. I may not be a medical doctor or a genetic. But Mr. Speaker, there's one thing that I know. Our only parents, our older parents, live healthier lives without this GMO. My father, Mr. Speaker, today, is still alive. He's 86 years. I dare say he seems stronger than myself. Yes. Mr. Speaker, what is the trick behind these poor people still being very, very strong? He doesn't use a walking stick at 86. In fact, the things he does in church, kneeling down, standing, he still does at 86. Mr. Speaker, I have asked and he has told me the secret is God's food. Mr. Speaker, because of business interests, we are now endangering our health. Because if doctors will tell us the truth is that natural fruits are what will save us, what will make us to not only live longer, we will even age gracefully. But all of these directionally modified foods, like we say, apart from the ethical issues, the other issues that they are modified, and you know, we want not to be, altering who we are. Mr. Speaker, even this, that's why it's good that the minister has said, let's invite the minister of agriculture. Even the fertilizer has been applied on all these plants. It has an effect on us. That's why, Mr. Speaker, with due respect, our women today cannot give birth like our grandmothers. How many women are going to be able to protect children? Because they are also genetically modified.
Thank you.